Now we are on the banks of River Indus. What we are seeing here is a Sakna monastery, and all these are, we are on the banks of Indus River, and the rock which are exposed on the banks are predominantly granites, and on the backside we can see foliated stratified layers of Tethyan Himalayan sequence. Indus River, which we are seeing today, originates from Mansarovar, and the place where it originates is known as Singe Khawab, the name which it derives from the source which resembles the mouth of a lion. Hence this river gets its name Sindhu, which gradually over the time distortions turned into Indus, Sindhu, Sindhu River, then Indus River, and then the Indus Valley Civilization and the Sindhu Valley Civilization, the greatest civilization which ever flourished on the banks of this great mighty river. Geologically, this is very significant. Why? Because it represents the culmination of suturing between India and China. Chinese plate. There are various theories which explained the initial collision, and which dates back to around 55 to 60 million years. But that's not the case. The Tethyan Himalayan sequence which we are seeing there are all full of fossils, predominantly plant fossils, which resemble very much to the fossils which you are finding in Kasauli. Hence, these are about 20 million years back. The marine fossils which you are finding here and also in Neoma are almost equivalent to the Sabatu formation. The fossil resemblance of the two different places shows homotaxial homogeneity in the basin at the time of deposition. The marine fossils, the near coastal fishes or plants which you are finding in Kasauli, which resemble Garcinia gluta, Combritum, Syzygium species, which are today nowhere found in Himalayas but are confined to Indo-Malayan region or Indonesian region, Java, Sumatra. So if that is the case, then these Tethyan Himalayan sequence, the stratified sequence which we have seen here, resembles or were deposited near the equator, very near to the equator. And then when Indian plate collided, the first collision took place with these sediments and they were drifted. Like, you know, this is, if this is China, this is India moving here. So India is moving here. So somewhere here, this is Indonesian formation, and then it strikes, takes all the sediments, and then leads to the evolution of the Himalayas. A very, very interesting thing happening here. A very, very peculiar thing happening here. And then this initial collision could have stopped the movement of the Indian plate, but that never happened. That never happened. Why? Because of these Ladakh batholiths, the massive Ladakh batholiths, they just intruded into it, you know. They just intruded into it, and then we are attaining the granites at this height, approximately 18,000 feet, the Khardungla range, and some peaks are even much higher. If the granites, this Indian plate, after it collided with this Tethyan Himalayan sequence right near the equator, they got this initial thrust And when the granites intruded, and then it started drifting at a very faster rate, leading to all the tests in Himalayan sequence, which is actually accumulation of different geological formations, right from Precambrian, Archean. We find stromatolites, we find ammonites, we find trilobites, whatever fossils which we can imagine we're finding in the Himalayas. So it's accumulation of various different geological formations which accumulated and were uplifted because of the movement of the Indian plate, and then this movement was enhanced by the intrusion of the massive granites, batholiths, that you're finding here right across the Indus River. And the Sakram Monastery is located on the granites, and the Masam Monastery right there is located on the Deccan Himalayan sequence. Very interesting thing happening here, very interesting geological phenomena. If one can visualize, then we can just talk for hours and hours to explain the mega geological event which took place, leading to the birth of Himalayas. I must say I'm very happy to be here for the last 20 years, trying to understand what happened, what transgressed at that time. You know, we can't even imagine the amount of volcanic activity, the heat which might have generated at that time. You know, that is that is why we were able to accumulate about 2,500 kilometers of batholithic formations here. And had these batholiths not been here, these Deccan Himalayas would not have been here. Because the initial momentum which it got after it drifted from Gondwana land, comprising of Africa, Australia, Antarctica, South America. So the initial momentum it got was sufficient enough to bring it to equator, or maybe after the collision with these Deccan Himalayan sequences, which were extending right from Indonesia to I think this, the whole belt continues to at that time from Indonesia to the equator, this unfolded Himalayan ranges extending to Arabia, where we are getting oil, you know. So for me, the bend from where the Deccan Himalayan sequence which you are seeing here, the sedimentary bend wherever it is happening, will be the cradle for the formation of oil, accumulation of oil. Here we are getting a lot of fossils. There are speculations that we may get oil here, but chances are very less because of the thrusting and then folding, and then I think all the oil from here have drifted and accumulated at this bend, you know, which have formed, you know. If this is Kasauli sequence, then this is Udhampur, Jammu Udhampur sequence, Dharamshala here, Udhampur here, and then we are getting this Ladakh, Kargil range, then Ladakh, and then Nyoma. So this bend, if stretched here, could be part of this great oil-bearing horizons in Arabia, you know. So likelihood of getting oil are very, very remote here, but you never know where some oil traps would have been formed. So we are heard just there are some coal-bearing horizons here. Next year, I want to do some tracks here to see the more fossil content here. I want to recover more fossils. So it is very interesting thing which is stored in place in the coming years. Till now, I'm so happy to be sitting on the Indus Sutra zone, enjoying the serenity of the winters. The river Indus has started freezing here on the banks, and I think by end of this month or first week of January, the entire river Indus will freeze and we can just walk on it. The famous Chadar expeditions which has just taken place. So this is all about today.